I'm going to take you through the conceptual project.
Scusate, can you hear
Global
us?
Health and Disaster Management. Yes, I can hear you. So I'm going to start with the definition of the concept. According to the World Health Organization, child abuse is also called maltreatance. It includes physical, sexual, emotional, or psychological mistreatment, as well as neglect. So this can occur in a child's home, or in the organization, schools, or community where the child interacts with. It implies taking into account the cultural norms that sanction physical punishment, which vary widely among professionals as well the wider public. So what you can learn from this, the child abuse, what is the implication of child abuse? The psychological, physical, and emotional can be affected. So when I will get to the critical evaluation, we'll get more. So another concept is about disaster management. So there is we talk about disaster when there is a disruption, a catastrophic event that occurs in a community, and this results in a economic loss, human loss, so many things are affected. So another concept is about the non-communicable disease. The non-communicable disease are non-infectious disease which are contagious, so they can be transmitted to, they can't be transmitted to one person to another. And those diseases, they last for a long time, but they can progress very slowly. Another concept is about universal healthcare. So this concept is just, there is a allocation, there's a kind of providing basic health care to all members of a society, regardless of the socioeconomic status. So this concept implies that everyone who is residing, who stays in a community, I can say this person is provided with health care services. They don't consider your health, your socioeconomic status. So it implies also all legal residents who are staying in a given area are given as soon as you have a legal document. But in our context, the current context, where we have a HIV condition, the care are not given to the person who are not a citizen. So they are only given to the citizen, those who are living in this country, not to the foreigners. Another concept is about female genital mutilation. Some people, they confuse this mutilation, they think it is a female circumcision. No, this procedure, it includes the partial or total removal of external female genitalia for cultural, religious, or other non-medical reasons. This procedure is often a part of culture in countries where it is practiced and can cause long-term health problems. So knowing this concept will help us to raise awareness of this practice in order to discourage it in our community, even though it is a rare practice. Another concept is about global health. You know, we are living, we are living in an interconnected world. no country, there is no country that can protect its border and the health of its population. So this can be done if the globe, the disease are addressed globally in the context, in the global context. So there are diseases like poliomyelitis, like tuberculosis. Those diseases have to be considered in the global context for them to be really addressed. So I'm going through critical evaluation. Okay. I think we had this concept of gender-based violence. You know, sorry. Okay, gender-based violence results as an expression of discrepancy in power between women and men. It includes, but not limited to, sexual abuse of children, rape, domestic violence, sexual assault, and harassment. So, you know, in our society nowadays, you know, the female, because of their gender, they are, can I say, they appear like weak. When I'm talking about this gender violence, we have to support women so that this thing can be discouraged in our community. There's another concept about the aging of the population. As you can see, there is a wide-ranging implication that have to be considered. This involves economic, political, and social process. So when we talk about aging of the population, it means that there is an increase in the median age of the population, in a given population. This is going to decrease the fertility rate and increase the life expectancy. What are the consequences? So I've talked about the non-communicable disease. So you will see the non-communicable disease, they are going to increase in the elderly people, and this issue of acute dizziness is going to decrease in with our elderly people. In terms of economy, there will be a kind of a burden. They are going to, because with age and non-communicable disease, there will be in terms of cost, it will ask more money to deal with all the people. They are at risk of cardiovascular disease,
Mr.
diabetes,
Ghazali?
and this condition, they will ask more money. So let me progress. The community diagnosis is one of the concepts that, but I didn't talk it much about it. The community diagnosis, this concept help us to assess the need, the health prob the problem, health issues that we are having in our community, in order to set priority. Like in our community, the HIV is more prevalent. So through a community diagnosis, it means that we are going to invest more money in dealing with a patient with HIV. So this is the importance of this concept. Universal healthcare in our community, as I told you, all the legal residents who are living in our country are given the basic health services, except for ARV. So the female genital mutilation is something that is, I can even say, is underreported in our community. So non-communicable disease, as I told you, are non-infectious and constitute the burden in all regions of the world, particularly in developing countries where the ongoing challenges of tackling infections probably due to the influence of globalization. So for a disaster to be entered in the database of United Nations, there should be there are these criteria. At least 10 people should be or more have to be killed. 100 people have to be affected, and a declaration of state of emergency by the relevant authorities or a request by international government for international assistance. I think that is all.